Jamin here. Make sure you subscribe so you don't miss any videos I produce. Big shout out to all the Patreon supporters who support this channel. You guys keep me going. Thank you. If you want to get access to my membership where you can get personal feedback on your dancing, let me know. Check out the link in the description. It'll give you all the details, hundreds of classes, all the stuff you need to reach your swing dancing goals. Now, guys, I've got to take a look at a new Invitational Classic today. I'm really excited about this one. Both of these dancers are so good at what they do separately from each other. Anthony Chan, Irina, she's so good at Balboa, and Lindy Hop. I can't wait to see what they've created in this routine, and I'm going to give you guys my honest opinion about it right after this.
That applause go on for our next couple, also from the USA, Irina Amzashvili and Anthony Chen.
All of me, why not take all of me? Baby, can't you see? I'm no good without you. My lips, I'll never use them. Take my arms, I want to lose them. Your goodbye left me with eyes that cry. Tell me, how can I go on, dear, without you?
About this one, man, there's so much to talk about this one. You know, first off, I have to say this. I really do have to say this. I love particularly Anthony Chan's dancing. He has so much natural creativity and playfulness, and he does it with rhythm. Like, there's this constant bounce in his dancing that I really appreciate. It seems in this routine that he smoothed out the edges a little bit, and which is something that's a little new for me in looking at his style, but I love his style. It's so playful. And Irina, what I appreciate about her is the diversity. Not just a great Lindy Hopper, but a superb Balboa dancer. And there's an elegance and there's a grace to her movement. My favorite section of this entire routine is when they're doing swing outs. And I can actually see their personality, the thing that I'm actually used to. I think that was really fun. All the footwork and just the light playfulness that was there, that part really stood out to me. I just love that about them. And I can't wait to see more of how they create together, because I feel like their styles are kind of contrasting a little bit And I feel like Anthony's style is a little bit more playful than her style. And so someone either has to imitate the other partner they're dancing with, or they continue to have a very stark contrast, which isn't a bad thing. And sometimes that creates something new. So I can't wait to see more. Now, let me talk about this routine, guys. So I have to give a compliment sandwich, right? That's what I'm all about. And sometimes I'm good at it and sometimes I'm not. But let me tell you what I don't like about this routine. What I don't like about this routine is that I hate it. I hate its guts. And the reason I hate this routine is not because of the dancers. Not at all. They're good at what they do. I just feel like I'm watching Dancing with the Stars. You guys know that show, right? Even Europeans and all these other countries have their version of this American show called Dancing with the Stars. And it's usually when you have a professional that meets up with an actor that's kind of a has-been. They no longer have hit movies or whatever, TV shows, and they work together and they try to make a routine that looks like they're both professional. And I'm not saying that this is the dynamic between Anthony and Irina. I'm not saying that they're both not professional or one's more professional than the other. I just think Ella Fitzgerald outdid them. It's weird. I think that song is way too powerful. She's so good and so professional and so emotional and so powerful that I don't feel like their choreography, as professional as they are, matches the intensity of the song. And she just outdoes them. That's what makes me feel like it's Dancing with the Stars. And because of that, that's why I hate this routine. Isn't that weird? I feel like there's certain songs that you should never touch unless you are coming out swinging. You're just coming out blazing, ready to take over the world. If you're not going to do that, you can't casually do it. If you casually do it, it's almost like you're trifling with it. It's not like you're serious about it. And it makes you look like, okay, it doesn't even make you look as good as I know you are, which is so weird. It'd be like the Indian version of Thriller trying to compete against the original Thriller. You just don't do it. So that's how I feel about this one. I loved the moments when they're doing swing outs. There's a little vestige of personality that I see when they social dance in this routine. And I love that when I can get a little glimpse of how dancers are on the social dance floor and a performance. And I have greater context as a professional. I've seen them do more. I've danced with them both. But in this routine, guys, the routine itself is not bad. It's constructed well. But in an alternate reality where Ella Fitzgerald doesn't exist, I might like it. But even then, I wouldn't say it's transcendent or just a colossal success in that sense. That's how I feel about it, honestly. I think they did a great job constructing it, but I think they're out of their league. You can't just play with Ella Fitzgerald or Jumping at the Woodside or any of those big epic songs that require the dancers to match the intensity at a level that we haven't seen before, so that when people watch your dance, they automatically think of the song. That's incredibly hard to do. So anyway, that's my thoughts on this one. What did you guys think about this routine? Let me know in the comment section below. I tried to be as constructive as I could without being nasty. So please try to imitate me what I'm doing. I like to do the compliment sandwich. So if you need to do that to control yourself, please do that, because I moderate my comments, guys. I want to build a culture where truth is edified and you can say the truth in love. You can be respectful, but you don't have to be nasty. Okay, so let me know what you thought about this one in the comment section below. If I don't see your comments below, hopefully I get a chance to see some of you in my class online. Take care.